When a messenger comes saying he has a message from God, offer him your hand and request him to shake hands with you. If he be an angel, he will do so, and you will feel his hand. If he be the spirit of a just man made perfect, he will come in his glory, for that is the only way he can appear. If he be an angel, he will do so. So you reach out. This is the grand key to know if the three grand keys by which you distinguish the correct nature of ministering angels. You reach out and say, hey, buddy, let's shake on it. And if he be an angel, he will do so. He'll say, put her there, pal, and he'll give you a firm handshake. And if he be the spirit of a just man made perfect, he will come in his glory, for that is the only way he can appear. Ask him to shake hands with you, but he will not move, because it is contrary to the order of heaven for a just man to deceive, but he will still deliver his message. Now, I like that he doesn't, like, say anything. Can't he just say, no, I really would, but, you know, I'm... I haven't yet ascended to my Father. Don't touch me not. I mean, why can't he say... Why does he just not move?
And does he look like a deer caught in the headlights at that moment? Or he's kind of like, oh, crap.
Damn it. They're applying that shaking hand thing.
If it be the devil as an angel of light, when you ask him to shake hands, he will offer you his hand, and you will not feel anything. You may therefore detect him. These are the three grand keys whereby you may know whether any administration is from God.
You know,
that's stupid.
Why are these devils so dumb?
Because I was always, you know, I was terrified of the devil. I was sure he was cunning and, you know, all this. But you can fake him out with a handshake every time.
Doesn't he read Doctrine and Covenants?
Exactly.
Because all you have to do is stand there. He doesn't even have to deceive. He just has to stand still. And you'll be like, oh, this is a being of light.
And the thing is, he can fake the light. He can fake the glory. He can do everything else. But every time he falls for the handshake.
Well, there's a law. The reason that is that is because there's a law that they have to obey.
Oh, come on.
There's a law. Is that handshake law?
They broke the law.
Yeah, there is.
Wait. Let's read verse 8 before, and then you can go on and explain this nonsense to me. Oh, verse 7, it is contrary to the order of heaven for a just man to deceive. The implication is that the just man doesn't reach out. So the just man and the devil are of the same material being. They're this fine spiritual matter. They were both born in the pre-existence, and one became a devil, and the other came to the earth life and died, and then presumably returned to his state. He has more glory now because he was just, but he's the same matter. He's the same material. And it says he can't shake your hand because he won't deceive you. The implication is that the devil will do it because he'll deceive. You're saying it's a law? The devils are bound by... They can cause all sorts of mayhem, rape, and they can do anything they want on this world. They can just literally think of the worst things you've ever heard, right? They can do that, but by gum, they sure have to shake your hand if the offer
They cannot one. Refuse a handshake. You can watch it.
Ha 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 ha